Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we are going to see 20 Docker commands that everyone should know. This video is for beginners, intermediate level and expert level persons as well. So do watch this video till the end and do subscribe to my channel. So let's get started. The first command is Docker search command. Docker search command can be useful to search available images on Docker Hub. Let's see, for an example, let's search for the images of Ubuntu. As you can see, here there are official and automated tags are also available. If official tag is okay, you know that this image is officially given by Ubuntu itself. So you can choose image name and image tag accordingly. Next command is Docker pull command. It is used to pull Docker images from Docker Hub to your local system. For an example, let's pull Ubuntu 18.04 image. As you can see, this Docker image is available in our local system now. To check all the available Docker images in our local system, you can run this command docker image ls. As this is my new system and I have just recently pulled Ubuntu 18.04 image, this is the only image that is available for now. Next command is docker run command. Here there are various tags available. --- name flag is to give name of the container. --- restart flag suggests that whenever this system restarts or Docker service restarts, it will always restart this container. -v is for volume mount. It is going to mount my own data directory from this system to the user share nginx html directory inside the container. As we already know, Docker container creates abstraction layer, so volumes of Docker container are not available outside. If we need to make changes, we need to mount those directories. -p tag is to expose port. It suggests that system's port number 80 will be mapped to container's 80 number port. Here, system's port you can change as per your availability. -d is for daemon mode and then the image name, which is nginx in our case. Let's run this command. Here, I have already put one index.html file in the mounted directory. Let's try and run this command. To check if container is running or not, run docker ps command. As you can see, it says container is created 20 seconds ago and it is up for last 19 seconds. As you can see, it is exposed to port number 80 of our system. So let's try and make a curl call to see if it is working. As you can see, it prints our expected output. Docker ps-a command shows you all the containers, which includes the running as well as stopped containers. Docker ps command will only show the running containers. Next is Docker exec command. This will allow us to log into the container in execution mode to execute commands if needed. Next is Docker commit command. If you have made any changes to the Docker container after it has been launched, then you can use this command to save that state of a container as a different image. Let's see an example. Here, -m, you need to give a message like what changes have you made. By -a, you need to describe the author name for this change. Then you can mention your container name or container ID. And after that, you can mention new image name. If we run docker images command now, we will see that new image has been created. Next is docker inspect command. Docker inspect command can tell you a lot about your Docker container or Docker image. This command can be run to the container or to the image. Let's see how that works. As you can see over here, it tells you all the information about the web container. Next is docker logs command. to see logs of the container. Here you can use tag hyphen F to see logs in the real time. Next command is very useful. It is docker cp command. As you already know, Docker container creates an abstraction and the file system of Docker is not available to the system. In that case, if you want to copy any file from container to your local system or from your local system to the container, you can use this command. First command will copy file on the slash path to the local path. Second command will copy local path's file to the container. Let's see how that works. Let's copy index.html file to a new location. I'm coming out of this directory. Here you can see there is no index.html file available. Let's run the command. Let's run the ls. As you can see, index.html file is now available. It has been copied from the container to your local system. Next is, let's stop this container. Container is stopped. If you run docker ps, you cannot see this container with docker ps-a and it says exited 8 seconds ago. Now the container is only stopped. You can start it anytime. To remove it completely from your system, you need to run docker rm command, which will destroy this container. By destroying, I mean that you cannot recover this container at all. If you run docker ps-a, then also you can see that no containers are available now. Hyphen F flag is used for forceful. If your container is not in the stopped state, rm command will not be able to terminate your container. In that case, if you run rm-f, it will stop and terminate your container. Now let's see some of the command related to the docker file. This command is useful to build docker image out of docker file. Let's see how that works. I'll go to the directory where docker file is present. As you can see over here, there are various docker files available. I'll just get one of them. It is node.js docker file. Let's build this file. Here hyphen t command means the docker image name. Colon, you can specify the tag, which is 1 in this case. Our docker image is built successfully. In the next command, we see how to tag this docker image. If you are pushing it to the docker hub or any AWS repository, any other private or public repository, you need to tag this image in specified format. Let's see how that works. Here I'm going to tag this image to my docker hub repository tag. Identical cloud slash node.js is my docker hub repository name. Colon 4 is the tag because I already have 3 images available. The next command is docker login. If you need to push this image to the docker hub in private repository, you need to log in before pushing this image. Let's log in. It will prompt you for username and password. Please enter them. Login is successful. Let's push this image. Docker image is pushed successfully. To know more about how to push images to private repository, please refer to the URL given here. Next is the docker rmi command. This command will remove docker image from your local system. Let's see how many images are available currently. Let's remove identical cloud node.js version 4. As you can see, it is not available locally anymore. These are very useful commands. Let's start with the second command first. Docker volume prune. If there are any miscellaneous space taken by the docker, it will remove those files. The docker system prune hyphen a command works not only for the volumes but for images, containers, networks as well. It will remove all the unused docker data. It may be unused Docker image, unused Docker container, stopped Docker container, etc. Let's try and run this Docker system print command. We have many Docker images available. It should remove all of them. As you can see, it has deleted one container which I have created just for this purpose, and it has also deleted various images. All the unused Docker images are removed. I hope this video was useful to you. If you like this video, please like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel. For more such content, visit my website www.identicalcloud.com. Thank you for watching this video.